Hello again, hitchhikers. This is Mindless Bile here, and we are now 20 days away from the release of No Man's Sky. Cannot wait and cannot believe we are now so close and with a guaranteed launch date. Today, I am here to talk to you about the topic I discussed in my, well, second to last video of how will I, Mindless Bile, play No Man's Sky. The biggest question here now is how will I play this game now that I plan to release videos on YouTube? Normally, I would be very extensive in my research, and I initially planned when I first heard about this game to even give my first planet a very long playthrough, trying to discover all the beacons and all the different things that I can on this planet before I take off into the universe. But now that I plan to do it on YouTube, I wonder if that is the most efficient way to play, because everyone's going to be wondering what's at the center of the universe. It seems to be it's going to be a race. And will I go on for that race? But I don't know. I still really can't answer the question myself. So far, the way I would like to play is I would really like to try to discover at least all the beacons on the planets, as I said earlier. You know, I go to one planet, I discover all that's, I don't know, all that's, you know, noticeably there that's standing out for the game to show you to go there. I'm sure I'll be missing all kinds of stuff. I might find some interesting things on the way to the beacons and all the different sites, but I feel like if I bought, even if I was just playing for myself, if I were to fully explore all these planets, I feel like I'd wear myself out on the game. And I think it would just be better off just to try to discover as much of the beacons I can and move on to the next interesting looking planet or to the next solar system, just for the sake of a speedy playthrough. Now, I asked myself also last week, how would I like to play? Would I like to play as the fighter, the combat expert? Would I like to play as the trader or the explorer? Or as everyone keeps on calling it online, as the space dick? Now, starting from last, I think the space dick would be very difficult because of the Grand Theft Auto style wanted system. I feel like you would either constantly be running away from the things you started, you would never be able to win the battles you started because the AI would only get stronger, and sooner or later you would have to lose. I don't believe the game would just, you know, run out of sentinels at one point to keep throwing at you. So I don't know how viable of an option the space dick would be other for hit and run type of attacks or supplies. I don't think you'd ever be able to start any full-scale wars with anything and survive. So I really don't think the space dick is viable for anything other than maybe a few fun videos and just as with Grand Theft Auto, just something fun to do. Now, skipping Explorer, I would say Trader is also one that I will not be playing. A lot of people I know really like the aspect of the games that really focus on the trading and commerce in the games, and I do like the concept of the ships, the Trader ships. I've heard, I don't know if it's just rumor or speculation, that they would have stealth modes and that they would have huge storage capacities. In games like Fallout and others in the past, I have really liked to make my character have as much of a carrying capacity as possible. It makes gameplay a lot less quicker without having to backtrack to places to trade. I'd hate to have a full inventory then have to leave the planet because I can't find a trading post. I don't know if you can be overburdened in this game or how that's going to work, which is another interesting point. But I just, other than the ship, I really don't like the concept of the trader. Not that I'm obviously going to trade, but I just don't see what that I'm going to make that center around my gameplay. Now, combat, I would like to say, you know, I'd like to go for combat, and I'm sure that's most people's, but I don't know how good I'm going to be at ship combat. I've had very few games where you actually fly a spaceship, and though this does look a little bit generic as compared to, you know, flight simulators and Elite Dangerous and other games that really focus on the flight mechanics, but I still don't think I, you know, would be able to be a full combat. My style is exploration, and I believe that's how I'm going to play. I like the concept of a ship with a, you know, faster light drive or fuel consumption or however the explorer ships are going to be. But once again, with the fighter, I do like the fighter ship. But I think all in all, I think I will be an explorer for my playthrough of No Man's Sky. Now, the last question I asked last time was, will I rush to the center or will I take my time? And I think I pretty much covered that in the first question with the fact that I think to a certain degree that now, yes, I'm going to have to rush to the center of the universe just in order to keep gameplay for my viewers and my videos a little bit more interesting, but for my own playthrough in itself, because sooner or later, the interest in the game will wane, regardless of how great the game is, at least for me. Sooner or later, after a month or so or two, sometimes it's lasted as long as three, but it usually doesn't last much longer than that. So I would like to at least get to the center of the universe before I stop playing No Man's Sky. So yes, I think that's all we have to talk about. Next time, I'm not exactly sure what we're going to be doing. I'm hoping the new trailer will be coming out soon, and that we can just put a video out for that, kind of breaking it down and seeing the new combat trailer, which is very going to be about the most exciting one we've probably seen so far. So once again, this is Mindless Bile saying if you like this video, to stick your thumb out, subscribe with me. You want to go to the center of the galaxy.